Well, it is a beautiful Sunday morning, and I'm driving through the streets of Kansas City. I just did a concert for a group here in Kansas City, the radio station KCMO. I did it on Friday. It went great. Had a great time. I want to thank everybody who was there. Thank you very much. So, I've got a little extra time. I've had my fill of barbecue and have always wanted to go to Marceline, Missouri. Now, Marceline, Missouri is in the middle of the state, I think. Got my GPS here. It's going to tell me where to go. Anyway, it's the boyhood home of Walt Disney. And if you've paid any attention to my program before, you know I'm a big fan. And I like to study Walt Disney and a lot of his techniques and where he's been and what he's done. And so we're going to the boyhood home. I guess there's a museum there and a whole bunch of cool stuff. So I'm going to have not a lot of time there because then I've got to go back another two. It's 2 hours there. And then it's 2 hours back to the airport. I've got to catch a plane today. So heading to Marceline, and you want to come along? Should be fun. Let's go. This is beautiful Kansas City, Missouri. Up there is what's called the Liberty Memorial, and that's a memorial to World War I, and that is where the official World War I museum is. And boy, this Kansas City is a place with a lot of history. This is Walt Disney's Main Street, USA. The real one.
Cause we've got a date tonight at 8. So meet me down on Main Street. Please don't be late. Don't make me wait. Just meet me down on Main Street. We'll take a ride on an old horse car.
Your attention, please. Santa Fe and Disneyland passenger train, E.P. Ripley, now loading on track number one for a trip around Walt Disney's Magic Kingdom. All aboard.
So meet me down on Main Street. They'll play Street.
So I've just spent the past few hours walking around Marceline, Missouri, which is Walt Disney's hometown. We're here at the Walt Disney Hometown Museum. Had a chance to drive by Walt Disney's boyhood home, which is still occupied. People still live there. It's a private residence, and right behind there is the thinking tree where he used to do a lot of thinking and dreaming. And I gotta tell you, I can't remember the last time I felt so calm and so inspired. This is just a wonderful place. The museum opens up in a few minutes, and looking forward to going in there and checking it out, although can't bring the video camera, sign out in front. But certainly would recommend you coming out here to the Walt Disney Hometown Museum. What's your name?
My name is Kay Mallers.
Kay Mallers, and you run the Walt Disney Hometown Museum?
I am the director of the Walt Disney Hometown Museum in Marceline, Missouri. I certainly am.
Now, more than just a director, I mean, this is your baby.
Well, yes, it was kind of thrust upon me. I was contacted by Ted Beecher, Walt's nephew and the son of Ruth Disney Beecher, that said, "Hey, Kay, come and get Mom's stuff. She wants you to have a museum," and so that's kind of how it happened.
Now, you took me through the museum a little while ago, and there's a picture of you looking at Walt in a movie. What was that story?
Well, it was in 1956. Walt Disney came back to dedicate our Walt Disney swimming pool and park here in Marceline. And he did a very special trip for the children here. He decided to have the Midwest premiere of The Great Locomotive Chase starring Fess Parker right here at our Uptown Theater. And when Walt Disney walked into the theater, all the children sang the Mickey Mouse Club song to him, but they had to teach it to them first.
So you didn't know it?
We didn't know it. We didn't get the Mickey Mouse Club yet in Marceline. So we sang the song to him, and then he looked at the children and he goes, "You know, you children are lucky to live in Marceline. My best memories are the years I spent here." And he put his hand on his hip and he pointed to the clock and said, "Time for the show." And they showed the movie for almost 24 hours straight so everyone could see it.
What do you remember about that day?
I remember about that day is that Walt and Roy Disney stood outside the theater and shook each of our hands as we came into the theater. And that was actually the first time I met Walt Disney. I was lucky enough that my folks had a brand new air-conditioned house. And so when the Disneys came in 1956, they stayed with my family.
Walt Disney stayed at your house?
Not only that, I was fairly precocious, imagine that, at 8 years old. And I walked up to Walt Disney and I said, "What bed are you going to sleep in?" He looked down and he said, "Well, what bed should I sleep in?" And I go, "The one in the pink room." So I took him by his hand and led he and Lily into my bedroom. So I can say Walt Disney actually slept in my bed.
Now, I was driving by and I went and saw Walt's childhood home, and it's still up, which is amazing, and it looks like people are living in there. Have you been inside there before?
Actually, I live there.
I'm sorry, what?
I live there.
You live in Walt Disney's house?
I do. I have this amazing muse. Yes, I do. So, it's...
Is it like a museum, sort of?
It's interesting. No, it's a private residence, but we kept the original part of the house original to the period, and Walt's little sister Ruth was a huge influence and asset to me, because I go, "Okay, Ruth, can you draw me a picture of, you know, how everything was laid out?" Because it had been changed a little bit in the 1930s. And so we tried to have it, you know, the doors upstairs are still crooked and all that, so we tried to keep it pretty much to the period.
Do you let people go in the house ever?
We really don't. Once a year we have a festival here in Marceline called Toon Fest, which I would encourage everyone to come to. It's an amazing, a lot of fun, third Saturday in September. And for that evening, we have honored guests, and we do a little tour of the house for that. But it's not open to the public. But
yes,
you can come to the Disney Farm anytime. And you can go see Walt's dreaming tree, and you can go see the barn where he had his first foray into show business, and you can even leave Walt a little message inside the barn.
That's just right kind of behind the house,
right? That's right behind the house.
Now, are you somebody that's been a Disney geek your whole life? I mean, not only do you live in Marceline, you live in Walt Disney's house. I mean, is this something that you dreamed of as a kid? I mean, how did somebody get that? That's the lottery jackpot if you're a Disney geek.
I just grew into it. It's just, I was born kind of into the whole thing. Walt and my dad were friends and partners on a project that Walt was going to do here in Marceline. He was going to do kind of a living history farm on the original Disney farm here in Marceline, and so Walt and my dad were partners on that project.
Well, inside the museum here, it's beautiful. Let's walk through it very quickly and tell me just as we go up there, what do we see when you go in there?
Well, what you're going to see is a restored 1913 depot, and the reason that we have a museum in this is because anybody that knows anything about Walt knows that Walt loved the railroad, and that love started here in Marceline.
As a matter of fact, this is the exact spot where he came into Marceline, isn't it?
There was a station here when he arrived as a child, a wooden station.
Okay.
But after that, on all visit back to Marceline, this station was built in 1913. So he, of course, would arrive at this station every time he came to Marceline. And we have great photos of him standing right out in front of it.
And inside there's all kinds of pictures and stories. And you're here. Are you here a lot?
Actually, we are open from May 1 through October 31st, and we're here every day except Mondays.
Well, it is a fabulous thing you've got here, especially for a Disney geek like me, and I sure appreciate it, and thank you very much.
Come along and see us anytime.
Here age relives fond memories of the past, and here youth may savor the challenge and promise of the future. Disneyland is dedicated to the ideals, the dreams, and the hard facts that have created America, with the hope that it will be a source of joy and inspiration to all the world.